就在俄罗斯入侵乌克兰爆发了全球的能源危机的时刻，我们也迎来了一场气候最大的一个异象。目前西班牙已经迎来40年来最早的首波热浪，马德里的气温高达摄氏40度，法国的热浪多地气温也超过了摄氏40度。我们刚前面报道了欧元希望能够 repower EU， 也就是它的整个能源计划，但是整个气候变迁可能不会给欧盟足够的时间，所以欧盟可能被迫在今年年底大幅的燃烧煤炭，所以这跟他们想要进行的对全球暖化各方面不要排放二氧化碳的重大目标完全抵触，这可以说是一个很大的一个恶性循环。而美国呢，美国就能幸免吗？当然不可能，我们都在同一个地球。美国的 Arizona 的首府凤凰城，也是现在台积电建厂的地方，现在气温高达摄氏46度，创下了104年的新高。美国的内华达州 Las Vegas 气温高达了43度，在加州某些地区是高达了48.9度，难以置信，像印度一样。而美国最著名的黄石公园因为大雨和洪水而被关闭的数日，在印度也出现了暴雨、高温天气，很多地方的气温高达了摄氏50度，在巴基斯坦用电猛增，整个停电的时间越来越长，气候的变迁、能源的问题，其实逼迫的人几乎没有什么太多的出路可以选择。
Tonight, weather extremes as destructive as they are contradictory. In the West, fires, historic flooding, and extreme drought all at the same time. The latest epicenter for devastation, Yellowstone National Park, an icon of Mother Nature, parts now underwater with unprecedented flash flooding just as the busy summer tourist season begins. Onlookers watching helplessly as this two-story home was swallowed by the Yellowstone River.The level so high and the current so strong.
这是美国黄石国家公园史上从未见过的猛烈洪水，逼得管理局34年来首次将5个入口同时关闭。华盛顿邮报称，上次黄石公园的与世隔绝是遭遇破坏性野火，如今是一波异常潮湿的天气系统聚集在太平洋西北部的热穹顶两侧，导致3个月的雨量在3天内降下，到处沿河流窜。而6月这个时间点，极端暴雨又遇上了融雪，共同形成了这个超完美风暴。
As you can see, some homes here in Livingston have already flooded. The local hospital, which was evacuated, remains under several feet of water, and now the winds are yet another force to.Deal with as the cleanup process begins.
讽刺的是，看似相邻地区的暴雨，却对加州近年持续的特大干旱毫无注意。美国西部多州近期再次陷入大规模森林野火，包括亚利桑那、新墨西哥及阿拉斯加州都持续受到高温干旱天气影响。今年山火面积已高出近10年平均1倍多。且破纪录高温还不断扩大范围，迄今已在全美酿成超过1亿人受灾。
Poles get as warm as the subtropical latitudes. The jet stream, which is normally sort of a belt that goes around the top of the planet and controls the weather, keeps the cool top cool and the warm at this time of year below that, it's wobbling. So it sort of forces these heat domes to move slowly.As a pattern, both in North America and Europe, as we're seeing.
气候学家认为，所谓的热盖现象正是今年夏天北半球极端热浪的主因。欧洲热浪预计也将提前报到。首当其冲的南欧西班牙，6月已经出现了20年最强的夏季前热浪，部分地区高温飙到摄氏43度。法国以往8月才会出现的40度高温，也已经在近日降临。巧的是，南半球澳洲此刻却遭遇数10年来最寒冷的冬天，雪梨迎来了1989年以来破纪录低温，极地风暴还带来了强风和巨浪。气候专家说，摄氏-6.5度的低温，过去通常只在6月最后一周出现，提早报道的寒流极不寻常，也让人忧心。
First reason is the climate is really warming quite fast now.The rate of warming of the climate is double what it was in 1990. And as a result of that, sea surface temperatures, which are really, the sea is really rocket fuel for hurricanes, has warmed dramatically. In the last 5 years, we've had well above average sea surface temperatures in the Atlantic hurricane formation areas.
美国国家海洋暨大气总署早在今年六月进入飓风季前，便率先发布预测示警。今年全球各地恐将难逃一连串极端气候灾难。
Is predicting an above normal 2022 Atlantic hurricane season, which would make this year the seventh consecutive above normal season. Specifically, there's a 65% chance of an above normal season, a 25% chance of a near normal season, and just a 10% chance of a below normal season.For the range of storms expected, NOAA calls for a 70% probability of the following ranges. 14 to 21 named storms with top winds of at least 39 miles per hour. Of these, 6 to 10 will become hurricanes with top winds of at least 74 miles per hour. And of these, 3 to 6 major hurricanes ranked as categories 3, 4,or five with top winds of at least 111 miles per hour.
更可怕的是，美国犹他州盐湖城的大盐湖，过去曾是当地重要的经济来源，也是动物天堂。但伴随着人口急剧增加与严重气候异常，湖泊面积40年来大幅缩减三分之一，水位也急速下降。科学家警告，最快今年夏天，湖中的飞蝇和虾子就会开始死亡，湖中的矿产开采也会停止。一旦大盐湖湖床高浓度的砷曝露增加，将让盐湖城周围空气变得有毒，因而形成一枚潜在的环境核弹。
We show that of the drought that was observed, about 40% of that drought's severity.Is explained by human-caused climate change.
根据美国官方公布的最新数据，人类过度燃烧化石燃料及砍伐森林，正导致全球大气中的二氧化碳含量比前工业时期高出50%以上。一份最新发表在《自然气候变化》期刊上的研究也显示，从前积累的碳排放量一直持续留存于大气中，当全球升温到摄氏1.5度。将无可避免加剧极端天灾风险。还有一份来自非洲、亚洲、美洲和太平洋地区等55个发展中国家共同发布的报告也忧心，全球暖化近来已摧毁部分应对气候变化脆弱的国家约1/5的经济增长。非洲多地还因而遭逢40年来最严重的旱灾，光是索马利亚就有约710万人正在挨饿，超过21万人处于饿死边缘。
As the drought worsens, children are among the most vulnerable. The UN predicts that if nothing is done, 350,000 of the 1.4 million severely malnourished children could starve to death.
值得注意的是，伴随着全球气温上升，各地武装冲突事件也翻倍发生。斯德哥尔摩国际和平研究所报告日前提出预警。全世界正进入一个新高风险时代，环境问题已演变成安全疑虑，对人类带来重大威胁。
Well, it's easy to imagine that a country that has a lack of drinking water and shares a water source, a river with neighboring countries, and because of climate change, there is less and less water to share. This could easily lead to social unrest and conflicts, and in the worst case, war. And we see that in many places around the world, but also how, of course, some of these problems lead to people leaving their countries. So we have so many more refugees and climate change refugees. So I think that there are a number of these elements showing the link between peace and security and growing environmental problems.
这将是未来人类面临的重大挑战，不只是越来越难以忍受的生活环境，还有越来越难以找到能安身立命的家园。
祝福所有的人，希望你在疫情的时候，也在现在任何时刻 平安。谢谢你收看今天文倩的世界周报，文倩的世界财经周报，我们下个礼拜见，拜拜。